Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Body movement. From this lesson today we have reached to the last point of the lesson. In that we will discuss about the locomotion in snake. So as you know, the snake is a reptile. It get crawl on the ground. But the very important thing is that how it get crawl on the ground. It doesn't have the legs, but still it runs very fastly, or still it crawling very rapidly on the ground. So how does it showing this movement? With the help of the very strong vertebral column present on the bow, present in the body of the snake. Okay, so the snakes is having the vertebral columns, and with the help of that vertebral column they can do the movements. Also the snakes are having, or this each vertebras are having the pair of ribs. Okay, each vertebra is having the pair of ribs, and that pair of the ribs are connected to the belly of the scales, at the bottom belly of the scales. Means these ribs are connected to the each vertebras are having this pair of ribs, and that pair of the ribs are connected to the bottom belly, or the scales of the bottom belly. From the bottom side of the body, these ribs are connected. Okay, so with the help of this flexible vertebral column, with the help of this pair of ribs which are connected to the belly, from the bottom they are connected to the scales of the belly, and also with the help of the strong muscles, the snakes can do the movement, or the snakes is showing the locomotion. Okay, and while doing the locomotion, the snakes forms like this loop like structure. Okay, the snakes is doing this loop like structure in this way, and this loop like structure helps the snakes to move forward. How? Because whenever the snake is forming this loop like structure, that time what happen? They push their body forward. Okay, they push their body forward. But how they push their body forward? They press their body on the ground, and by pressing the scale of the body of the snake helps the snakes to move forward. Okay, so in this way, by making these loops, the snakes can do the forward movement, and while doing that loops, the body of the snakes push itself on from the ground and take a forward steps. Okay, so in this way there the snake is too long. While moving, it forms a very number of the loops which helps the snakes to run rapidly on the ground, or to crawl rapidly on the ground. Okay, so in this way the snakes is showing the locomotion with the help of this flexible vertebral column, with the help of these ribs, and with the help of the strong muscles. Now we will discuss about the locomotion in fish. How the fish is showing the locomotion? So might be you have seen the fish in the aquarium. Aquarium means what? It is the place where we are keeping the fish. Okay, like that we are having the fish tank at our home, like that big aquariums are there. In that we are keeping the different types of the fish. So that is what? Aquarium. So if you have observed the fish in the aquarium or at any places, then you can see that the shape of the body, or the body shape of the fish, is narrow at the mouth part, and at the tail portion also it is narrow. Okay, so the fish body at the mouth portion and at the tail portion, it is narrow, or we can say it is the tapir. Okay, but the middle portion of the body is bigger as compared to the tail portion and as compared to the mouth portion. Okay, so this type of the body structure of the fish, it's called as what? Streamline body. Okay, streamline body, that is only what? Boat shaped body. Okay, so the fish is having the tapir portion at the tail and at the end. It means what? The head and the tail portion is narrow as compared to the remaining part of the body, and that forms the streamline body shape. It means what? Boat like body, which helps the fish to move easily or to swim easily in the water, and helps to break the current of the water. Current of the water means what? The wave water, the sea water is having continuously wave. Okay, so in that wave also the fish can do swimming easily with the help of this streamlined body. But how the fish is showing the locomotion? How the fish is showing the movement? So the fish is showing the movement in a sideways by making the wave-like position, by making the wave-like position of their body. Okay, and also with the help of the strong muscles which are present in their body. So the fish is showing the locomotion by making the wave-like motion sideways. But how this motion is possible? Because of the strong muscles which are connected to the backbone. So because of the strong muscles which are connected to the backbone, the fish can do the easily locomotion in the water. So they are making the different wave-like structure on their body. So here I can say that this is the one fish. Okay. So they are forming the different waves. If the waves is on the head portion, then the next wave forms on the tail portion. Means what? Oppositely they are forming the waves, and that waves give the jerk to the body of the fish and helps the fish to move ahead in the water. Okay, so in this way they are forming the waves. Why? Because that waves gives the jerk to the body of the fish, and that jerks helps the fish to move ahead in a water. Next one is that there are the fins present on the body of the fish. Okay, there are the fins present on the body of the fish, and that fins, we can say that the fins which are present on the body of the fish helps the fish to balance its body and to find a direction. So the fins which are present on the body of the fish helps to balance the body of the fish and also for the direction while swimming. Okay, so these fins which are present on the body of the fish, these are useful to maintain the body and the direction while swimming. And also these fins which are present on the body of the fish acts like a brakes. Okay, so whenever the fish want to stop while swimming, these fins acts like a brake. Next one, the fins which are present on the tail portion. Okay, the fins which are present on the tail portion, they act like a radar. Okay, radar means what? It helps to find out the direction in the water, or while swimming it helps to find out the direction. Okay, so in this way these are the two types of the fins which are present on the body of the fish, and in this way by making the sideways wave-like motion, the fish is doing the locomotion with the help of the flexible, with the help of the strong muscles which are connected to the flexible backbone. Okay, so this is all about fish. Now we will discuss about the birds. So like a fish, the aeroplane, boat, ships are also having the streamlined body. Means what? At the end they are taper, and at the middle portion they are bigger. Why? Because that ship like boat or that boat like shape of any type of the object helps them to move easily in a water. Okay, so in this way we can say that the next locomotion in the animal, that is the locomotion in birds. So as we know, the birds are flying very high in the sky. But how they are flying, which are the body features present in the birds which helps them to fly in the sky? So let's discuss about the body features of birds. Which body features helps the birds to fly? Okay, the first one we can say that the four limbs of the birds are get modified into wings, and these wings helps to fly them in the air, and the hind limbs helps them to walk on the ground and for the perching. Now perching means what? To hold the branches of the trees very properly whenever they are sitting on the branch of the trees. Okay, so in this way the four limbs are get modified into wings and helps them to fly, while the hind limbs helps them to walk on the ground and also for the perching. Okay, but see, all the birds are not flying. There are the some birds which are doing swimming also. We can say that what? Swan and the ducks can do the swimming also. Okay, now the next one we will discuss about the birds. The birds are having the hollow bone. Okay, why they are having the hollow bones? Because of that hollow bones, the weight of the body of the birds becomes so light, and it is easily, because of that light body weight, they can easily fly in the air. Next one, the muscles, or there are the strong chest muscles. The strong muscles are present in the chest area, which helps the birds to take. The birds have the powerful chest muscles, which helps them to flipping their wings when they are doing the flight, or during the flight to flip their wings, that chest muscles helps them. Next one, we can say that the birds are also having the streamlined body shape, which helps to cut the current whenever they are moving in the air. Cut the current means what? The air, there is a very high air as we are going up the height. Okay, so in that high speed of the air also the birds can fly. Why? Because of this streamlined body shape. Okay, so these are the certain features about the birds. So the bird, fish, aeroplane, sheep, boat, all these are having the streamlined body shape. Why? To do the easily movement in the particular medium. Okay, so this is all about the locomotion of snake, fish and birds. This is all about today. Here we have completed our lesson. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and up till we will meet in the next video for with the next point. And for today, thank you.